everybody, I'm Angela Lombard, and I'm going to be showing you my race car. So the goal of this project was to build a Mindstorm NXT race car. Another goal was to actually code it with Bluetooth and to have a remote control that's controlled via Bluetooth. So the design of this car was actually to work like a real car. The real wheels are equipped with gears to give it more speed, and the front turns just as a real car would. The design of the race car came from the NXT website's program's website. So building. So this car required a lot of different pieces, including axles, beams, gears, and of course, the brain of the robot, which is the microcontroller. The technology behind the building pieces, so there's actually three servo motors. Why it requires three is the two are used for the real wheels to give it speed, and then the last one is used for pivoting the front, and that gives you the great steering that this race car has. So programming it. The programming of it took a little bit longer than expected. It was my first time using the LEGO Mindstorm programming app, so I used all the features to get to Bluetooth, and I learned how to use buttons, push buttons, and so how it works is this is the messenger, and my race car is the receiver. So when I press a button on here, it sends a message via Bluetooth to my race car to either move, stop, turn right, or turn left. When I release the button, it will always stop. So testing. Testing is really important. I had to test a lot this time. Certain things with the Bluetooth, knowing if you're doing the right turn, knowing if you're going forward, going backwards, making sure all your cables are plugged into the right port is really important. So testing is super crucial to make sure that you have everything set up properly. Rethink. So something that I had to rethink was the length of the cables. On the car, the length of the cables that they suggest were way too long, which caused the front windshield to keep popping out. So what I did was I had to change the length of the wires and actually go to shorter wires. I also had to rethink how to do Bluetooth. Instead of turning right and left, I had to learn how to work with the one servo motor in the front and go forward and backwards with the certain wheels depending on if I wanted to go left or right. So play. So now I will give you a demo of the car. So this button allows you to go forward. And then this one lets you go backwards. And then this one will turn it to the right and turn it to the left. So I can go there and like this, and reverse, go to the right. Oh. Okay, and thank you for listening to my presentation. Yeah.